Welcome to Petal Savvy. I'm Erin, and today I'm going to show you how to create a beautiful elevated centerpiece using hydrangeas, roses, spray roses, and greenery for your special event. I'm going to show you the tools, the supplies, the mechanics, everything that you're going to need to design this, including what kinds of flowers we're using, the recipe, the stem count, as well as considerations on transporting it at the end and getting it to your venue, and even how to select your riser. So first, let's talk about the tools and supplies that we're going to need to create an elevated arrangement to go on top of a riser or tall vase for your special event. So the first thing that we're going to need is our foam, a lomey dish. I like using a 9-inch size. Clippers, your anchor tape, a knife comes in really handy to cut the foam. You can also just use a butter knife if you don't have a florist knife. And then I like having a smaller vase to put your foam on top of while you're designing. It helps if it's a little taller, that way you're not trying to design directly on the table. And then you are going to need your riser. And what makes a good riser for a tall centerpiece is that it's sturdy and strong, and it's not going to wobble and not going to fall over. You don't want to use those little bitty Eiffel Tower vases. Those things are terrible and not safe for something this heavy, because this foam gets really heavy. Okay, so let's talk about how we created our foam vase here. So what I like to do is take our foam and cut it so that you have 2/3 of the brick. And I take 3 pieces of foam and get 3 pieces that are 2/3 of a brick. If you're doing a giant arrangement, you may want to do a larger lomey dish and just do 3 full bricks of foam, or even 4 full bricks of foam. And what I like to do is place them side by side in the dish and tape them down. And then I take the next one and do a crisscross across the top with the tape. And then I go all the way around to secure the tape so that this thing is not gonna fall over. You may drink some water, but you wanna make sure that this foam is staying in place, because this is really, really heavy. I do like to soak my bricks of foam before putting them in the dish and taping them down. You can also just pre-assemble and soak it all as one, but I just want to make sure that all of that foam is absorbing as much water as possible. And so for me, I just feel more comfortable soaking the bricks individually or in a big tub before cutting them and putting them down into your dish. The recipe we're going to be using today for our arrangement is 20 stems of full-size roses. Today we are using soul roses. We're using a dozen spray roses, 14 stems of premium hydrangea, 10 stems of Israeli ruscus, and 5 stems, this is only 5 stems guys, 5 stems of Italian ruscus, plus our foam and our lomey dish. Let's get started. To begin our arrangement, we are going to start with our hydrangea. And what I'm going to do, we have 14 hydrangea. I'm going to decide before I start kind of where I want to place them. And I'm going to do 3 in the top, 6 in the middle, and then 5 around the bottom, kind of like in a tighter area. So the 6 in the middle will be wider, and then the 5 will be tighter in. If you're not sure how long to cut your stems, you can kind of hold it up to your foam and see where it would be good. You know you want your stems to be in just a couple of inches, so that's kind of how you can measure against your foam. Here we have our 3. That is kind of going to be the height of our arrangement. We are going to have roses and greenery also popping up, but this is kind of the foundation of our arrangement, is the hydrangea. So now I'm gonna come back in and do 6 around the middle and 5 around the bottom. And the ones in the middle are gonna be a little fuller out here. And then the ones toward the bottom are gonna be a little tighter. So I'm gonna start placing those now. Okay, so now we have all of our hydrangea placed. Obviously, we have lots of gaps. You can still see the foam. We don't want to see the foam eventually. So what we're going to do at this point is come back in with our greenery and kind of fill in and cover the majority of the foam, especially around the bottom, because when your guests are sitting at the table, they're going to be looking up and they're really going to see kind of the middle and the bottom of the arrangement. So that's where you want to give the most attention. I'm gonna cut my greenery into sections. There's not a whole lot of usable stuff down here. There's a little piece right here. And when you cut your greenery, you wanna make sure that you are cutting as close to the leaf as possible. That way, you're not getting little blunt stems like this. It's not as cute to have that stem poking out. So we're gonna cut it so that it looks more like the natural end of the stem. And we're gonna do that to all of our greens. Kind of place them throughout. And as we go, I'm gonna do about half of the greenery now and then save the other half for after when we have all of our flowers in place so we can really fill in and see where we're gonna need that coverage. Okay, so we cut all the greens. We have a big pile of greens. I love the Italian Ruscus and I love this fun, playful line that it has, and we really want that to kind of come out. This is not gonna be a typical tight, round arrangement. It's gonna have some movement, it's gonna have a little body, and it's gonna be beautiful. So I am going to be placing these. I'm gonna look for kind of the biggest gap. So you can see right here we have a big gap. And I'm going to place it kind of in an upwards position so that it's coming out. So I always think of it like a firework or like a nice fern that's just kind of naturally growing. So you want to take that into consideration with your stem placement and really give it a nice natural feel by how you place your stems. So I'm going to go around, give everything a turn as I go, find all those big gaps, and just start filling in with this beautiful greenery that we have. And especially, like I said, around the bottom, we wanna make sure that it's all filled in. And the greenery at the bottom, it's good to kind of point it downward a little bit. Up here, we want it kind of up and beautiful, but at the bottom, we want it kind of cascading down. And that's really gonna help, again, when your guests are looking up, it's just gonna be a very beautiful, natural looking arrangement. Now we are at the point where we have most of our gaps filled in. We have our greenery just being all beautiful and gardeny. And now we're gonna come in with our full-size roses. And what I'm gonna do is do half of the full-size roses and then half of the spray roses. And then we're gonna come back again with half and half. That way we can really see where we need to fill in the gaps. So before you start with your roses, you may want to spin them open or reflex them to make them a little bit larger. And to spin them open to make them bigger, all you do is hold them upside down and give them a little spin. Make sure that they're all nice and fluffy. You want to remove thorns, leaves, scar petals, all of that ahead of time. And this is stuff that I like to do before I begin designing, you know, the day after I get the flowers, the day before I really do the design. That way everything has time to open, it's beautiful, and it's ready to go for you. That way the designing portion takes a lot less time. You know, one of the things that takes the longest time is all the prep work. So make sure you have a lot of people to help you when you're doing all of your prep work for your wedding. Now going in with our roses for this one, I do want them to be popped up a little bit higher. So I'm gonna kind of measure against my foam like I was saying. That way you can kind of determine where you want to cut the stems. You only want the stems to go in about 2 inches into the foam. There you go. So you can see how it's popped up and nice and high above the level of the hydrangea. So I'm going to go in with our first 10 roses, well, 9 now, and then our first 7 Centa spray roses. Okay, so here we have half of our roses and spray roses in place, and you can already see this arrangement is so beautiful. We give a little spin, forgive me if my lazy Susan has any little squeaks. It doesn't, yay. I feel like a couple of these little pieces of greenery. This one's a little too long, so I'm gonna push it in just a little bit. You always wanna stand back as you're designing and have a look and see what you're big pieces look like. Luckily I have the camera to look at and see how it's turning out. But yeah, this is looking absolutely beautiful. And now I'm going to come in with the rest of our flowers and greenery, flush it all out, and it'll be done and ready to put up on top of our riser, and I'll show you how to do that too. Okay guys, here is your classic centerpiece all done. You can do this in any color scheme that fits your wedding if you're doing a classic look with a slight garden feel. If you wanted to do a really clean classic look without greenery, you totally could. You would just need to use a little bit more hydrangea. Maybe do 20 hydrangea instead of 14 and really get that tight ball of hydrangea and then pop your roses in on that. And it's the same basic principle. And like I said, you can do this in any color scheme that roses and hydrangea come in. So now you have your big, beautiful arrangement, and that's all you have to do to make it. But how do you transport it? How do you get it up on its face? So transporting these, I highly recommend having somebody with a big SUV or even getting a U-Haul if the weather is not too hot. You don't want to put these in a back seat because they may smush against the back of the seat. The flowers themselves, if you have the arrangements in the back of the SUV, they can nestle in a little bit and they can touch one another, but you don't want this touching anything that's like hard or the side of a vehicle or anything like that. So I have our riser down here on a bench because it's so tall that you wouldn't be able to see it. So we've put it on a bench so you can see. This is our riser. Again, you want to have something really sturdy. And ours is flat. It's not like a vase that has, you know, an indentation to hold that lomey dish. So it's usually a good practice to put some glue dashes or some double-sided tape on top of this if you have something that's flat like this to really secure this to the riser. So I'm just gonna scoot it on over here and show you. Now be mindful when you pick these up, they may spill a little water, whenever you put the stems into the foam, they're going to displace some of the water. So you may get some drippage. Don't be surprised if that's a concern when you're transporting lined the bed of your vehicle with towels or cardboard and towels, you know, a tarp, something to keep your interior clean. So see, we got some drips right there. And we're just going to put it on our riser. We want to make sure that it's centered. You know, if it's on a table, you want to give the table a bump. Make sure that it's not going anywhere. And you want to just kind of give it a look, just like as if you're sitting down. And like I'm seeing, this one is kind of pointed more up. So I'm going to adjust him just so that he's like prettier for somebody who's sitting at the table. I go around and kind of check all of that and see if I like the placement of everything. Make sure that you can't see any of the mechanics, which is that foam and the tape and whatnot. And once you have it the way that you want it, you're good to go. And that's it, guys. That's really all you have to do. Thank you for joining us for this Petal Savvy course on how to arrange an elevated centerpiece for your wedding. We showed you the tools and supplies that you were going to need, the flowers, the recipe, the mechanics, and how to put it all together. I hope you found this helpful. If you did, please like, share, and subscribe, and visit us at PetalSavvy.com.